In this video, we're going to take a look at my new little project, a motobecane mobylette cady. At the moment, it doesn't seem to really want to run. When I bought it, I was told that there was no spark on it, but actually there was a spark. I cleaned the points, and that made the spark a little bit brighter, but there was spark. But the timing is a bit off, so let's take a look at that. Okay, this moped is a little bit weird from what I'm usually working on. Normally you can adjust the timing by turning the back plate a little bit and of course setting the points. But on this one, it got this cam which is removable and is actually just pushed on. It's a push-on fit that you can take off and then turn and put in and then turn the ignition timing that way. The problem with this bike is that this has moved by itself. You could see when I removed the big nut holding the flywheel on, or the magneto on, it was not very tight. And this is because it wasn't tight and it has loosened and this has turned a little bit, thus moving the timing, the ignition point, the timing point. So we are going to try to fix that. And right now I've removed the two wires coming from the coil because that makes it possible to test the points when they open and close. So if I put this one into here and this one to the chassis, you can hear now that the points are closed. And if I turn the engine, you can hear now the points are open. Now they are closed. Now they are opened. And what we want is the points to open, to become an open circuit when the piston is 2 millimeters before top dead center. And there's no easy way to do it other than to pull this off, try a little bit to one of the sides and put it back on and test it again to see if we got the point. I rigged up this little thingy that I can take and put into the, I've taken the spark plug out, by the way, into the plug hole up here and push it down. And then I can see when the engine turns. And then you can find the top right now. That's the top. So if I take that 2 millimeters back, one, and two, and of course I need to hold my hand very steady to do this and it's not completely precise, but it will do, and I will double check it many times. So what I'm going to do now is to take off the cam because the timing point is not the right place. Like that, we got it off. Pretty tight bugger. What I'm going to do now is to put the engine at 2 millimeters before top dead center. This is here. Now I will fit the cam loosely. And then I'm going to find the spot where the circuit opens. Maybe I should turn this on. This is right here. And then I'm going to tap the cam back on. So I got it within 1 millimeter, I think, from the perfect point. I tried many times and it's extremely difficult, but I think and hope that this is okay. I'm gonna give this thread some Loctite to prevent it from coming loose. And we're going to try to refit the drive belt. This should not be tightened up too much because that will make the clutch not work, but I do not want it to come off either because it keeps the entire assembly together. Now, let's see if it runs. Open up the fuel thingy, which is of course pushing down and not pulling up. Pretty counterintuitive. Let's see if it works. Yeah, it actually runs. It doesn't run perfect. It seems to stumble a little bit, especially going uphill. Going downhill, it's perfect, but it most likely would be without the engine as well. But it seems to be driving okay. There needs to be some tweaks. I think some tweaks are needed on it, and it feels like the engine is struggling a little bit. I might have to look at the exhaust because it might be clogged. It seems as though it like to go into four stroke instead of two stroking. And that is often because of the exhaust, in my experience at least. But it works, and that's the most important bit. And the light works and everything works. It's a very nice moped and very French. I like that. It's a very small engine, 49 cubic, I think it is, with a belt driven clutch system and a bicycle thingy if the engine doesn't work, which I think is a very good thing to have on a bike like this. And yeah, it's called a motobecane mobylette cady. And yeah, you started by driving along on the with the pedals, and then the engine will grab on if when the speed is high enough, and you can help it by depressing this one, which open a valve in the top of the engine, letting the compression out, making it easier to get it up to speed. And then when you release it, the compression comes back and the engine starts, and you can shut it off the same way. It's a bit like a Velo Solex. That's the same way that's done. The ignition system is pretty complicated, and there's a lot of coils everywhere. There's also a coil right here. I haven't really figured out how it all works, but it seems to be working at the moment, at least. So it's a funny little moped. Thing I like the most about this moped is the fuel level gauge, which is this thingy that you can put down and then take a reading. Oh, there's so much fuel. That is very, very simple, but I actually like it a lot. Yeah. This is a nice little moped. It could be running better. So could the book. But it's okay. In Denmark, you can only go 30 kilometers per hour on a moped. So the engines are very much muffled down to achieve such a low speed. So yeah, this is all for now. See you in the next one.